Aspire. This documentary is based on aspiring young students to strive towards achieving their dreams. We will now take a look at the UK Afrobeat's number one artist, Sona. It's your boy. Hey, it's your boy, young be something. I go ginger, you the something. Ginger, you the long thing.
I think growing up in a household where music was a big thing, really. My dad was the choir master at church as well, so kind of took part going to church, playing music. Just growing up listening to music in the car, my mum's driving around and that, so yeah, music was a part of me. School, I kind of just excelled in the music class, so I kind of knew from there. So from school, playing drums in class and that, going to festivals and doing steel drums and all these kind of things. Went to college and did music tech, then after that went to uni. Then that's actually when I started doing music. So from uni, obviously you got a lot of friends in uni and them kind of things, just pushing the music through that. I think I like football and basketball and stuff like that, but music was more the thing that was me. So I just kind of went with that, really. I think it's just how I'm feeling at the time and the beat. Because like with Bami Dele, I got to visit the studio and I just heard the beat and I was thinking, right, what would I say on this? Then I started thinking, oh, what would I do if I was out? And then I started thinking, wow, when man goes out, people show man love. Bami Dele, Bami Dele, Bami Dele, Bami Dele, yeah, they show me love.
Bami Dele, Bami Dele, Bami Dele, Bami Dele, yeah, they show me love. Let me let it, let me let it, let me let it, calling my phone, yeah, they show me love.
So more time is just how I'm feeling and the vibe of the beat, really. I'm still aspiring, but I've made like some of my dreams reality, but I need to make more of them. I got a lot of dreams, so I need to continue, you hear me?
For all aspiring footballers, both young and old, we take a look at a young professional footballer, Joe Ariba.
I think when I was a kid, like my brother, he used to play football and just wanted to be like him. So I just found a love for football because I just wanted to play football after watching him and everything. I was playing at Staines as an under 18, and then after that, when I was 18, in my under 19 season, I was playing for the first team, played about 20 games for them, and then my manager Marcus Gell at the time, he played with my under 23's coach Jason Newell, and then he just spoke to him for me and said, oh, I've got a player for you that I know and I think he's very good, like. So he spoke to him, Jason Newell gave me a trial, and then from there, literally the rest is history. I've been at Charlton since then. Made a breakthrough this season because my manager Carl Robinson showed some faith in me, and yeah, this is where I'm at now.
What is it about Joe that you think that makes him so impressive?
A young Patrick Vieira, some ways with his leggy range and his quality and his appetite to get around the pitch. From the moment I walked to the door, I was told about him. I've seen him in training. I trusted him to start, make his first start at MK Dons, and thought he was one of the best players on the pitch. So when kids take the opportunity, I knew his contract was coming to a close. I think it was important that we wrapped it up very quickly, and I think I'm really ecstatic about him. Listen, Charlton Athletic have a rich history of developing young players, and I'm certainly sure he will go right to the top and hopefully through this football club.
Challenges, I would say, when I was at Staines, I was thinking about to stop playing football because it was just getting tough, going everywhere from Staines and just not seeing any results. So I think that was my biggest challenge, and I'm just happy that like I didn't stop playing because where I'm at now. Lionel Messi, because I think no one's just on his level. Like, he can do what he wants when he wants. So I think, yeah, just how he is and everything. I just think he's just too good. No one can relate. Say family, like I just want to do it for them. Nice, my mum and dad. To be honest, that's the main thing that keeps me going. It's surreal, like. I literally heard everything, but I wasn't like there, like I was zoning out, and I'm looking at my manager walking off, and he's telling me like clap everyone because they're clapping you, and then I've looked around and just started clapping, see everyone clapping for me, and I was just like, no, this is mad, like I didn't know what to do. I mean, in certain aspects, yeah, I would say like where I'm a professional footballer, but I'm nowhere near where I want to be, so I mean, I've still got a lot of improving to do.
Now we're taking a look at the classics teacher and scholar.
Well, the thing I remember about tossing straight away, as head of sixth form, I have to do a lot of interviews. So I was interviewing lots of students from our own school, but also interviewing students from different schools. And I think the thing about tossing, he stood out because he turned up looking absolutely immaculate in this sharp suit, carrying, I suppose, what would have been a record of achievement with him. And that, for me, showed a student straight away who was prepared to go above and beyond what is expected of them. So he turned up with the record of achievement and he sat down looking immaculate and started to show me all the things he'd done. And it was so obvious to me immediately that he was personable, articulate, and I suppose the best thing about him, a real thirst for knowledge. But I could see that sense of humour and a sense of cheekiness. And there was something about him that made me sit up and take note and actually made him stand out above other students. So he got my interest straight away and we had a wonderful interview, and I knew straight away that he was the kind of student that we wanted in the sixth form. And that's how it carried on really for the rest of the time that he was with us. It wasn't always perfect. We forgot ourselves at some time. We were never rude. He was never rude, never offensive, always polite, always apologetic, but we had some lively moments, shall we say. I remember one that involved a bit of water, which I'm sure Tossin will remember. Say no more. I mean, he was just so helpful. He went for the head boy of the whole collegiate, and his interview, once again, was above and beyond most of the others. I think the difference is he knows how to take things seriously, put the effort in, put the thought into things, and his answers were meaningful. And he got the job. He became head of the college in terms of the student body, and thereafter was just a wonderful head boy who did so much for the school and so much for the students. And I think my enduring memory, apart from the charity events and the talent, Riddlestown's Got Talent, he had initiative. So I never had to ask him to do anything. It was almost done before I needed it. He couldn't help me enough, and he was an absolute joy to work with. Well, I've been teaching for 32 years, which is a phenomenally long time. Actually quite depressing when a lot of the teachers are coming along and I'm not quite old enough to be their grandma, but it's getting that way. I taught in 6 schools. 4 of those schools were in very difficult socio-economic areas, and 2 of the schools were academically high achieving. I'm a classics teacher. I don't believe in private education, so I'm very proud to say that I've taught classics and Latin in state schools for the whole of those 32 years. I became head of sixth form at Riddlestown 10 years ago now. I've been left a year. I've gone back to university to do a master's in the reception of the classical world, which is a niche market, but it's something I enjoy. And I'm not quite sure what I want to do afterwards. I will possibly do some voluntary work and travel. I absolutely love traveling. I am a passionate believer in educating students. I absolutely love my job. There was never a day when I didn't want to go. The reason I left has got nothing to do with the school. It was a wonderful school. It's because I realised it was time to do something for myself and challenge myself and start doing new things. So that's my story. It doesn't matter if you fail at things, first of all. It's not the end of the world if you're in crying your eyes out or terrified. What matters is that you actually stick at it and try to be the best you can. And you only get out of things what you put in. And I think we can see those qualities in Tosin. I think that's what's got him through, this resilience, this thirst for knowledge, this enthusiasm for life. And I just love that.
Hi, my name's Harry Kinzariti and I'm a GB 100 metre sprinter. I'm currently at the age of 29. I probably started athletics when I was about 13 years old. As we all participate in school athletics, I actually got into it by playing a game of British Bulldog. More so, I was chased by a dog whilst we were playing this game. Unfortunately, there was a coach nearby who saw the potential and speed that I had. I did fall over in the process whilst this dog chased me, but I'm still here to tell the story. But fortunately, someone gave me some advice on where to go, and here we are at Sutton Arena, and this is where it all started. So I train 6 days a week. It ranges from, you know, acceleration sessions, plyometrics, endurance-based sessions, that's more speed, speed endurance, and weights. But at the same time, it's, you know, making your dreams a reality is having structure, it's having a goal, it's having a good philosophy in terms of how you want to treat every day. And it's more so the factor of how you deal with challenges, because nothing is easy in this world, whether you come from, you know, a wealthy family or poor family. It's just taking it in your own strides and your own steps and figuring out how you can be the best you. I mean, ways that I thought about being successful is just the fact of having a positive mindset. I walk into every situation being positive. I remember winning my first World Youth title. You know, I just said to myself that I'm not here to make up numbers. I wasn't meant to win that race. I wasn't the fastest person there on the day on paper, but I said to myself, I'm not here to make up numbers. I'm here to do something. I'm here to achieve. And that's what you got to tell yourself. Being positive is a key that we don't use enough. If you dream it, you can, and believe it, it can happen. You know, the following year, you know, I won the World Juniors, made the Olympic team when I was 19. I got my first senior world medal when I was 20. So, you know, there was a progression there. But through that process, I had upsets. I had my first stress fracture. I was in a back brace at the age of 17, 18. So after winning the World Youth, the World Juniors, I was on top of the world. I had a Nike sponsorship. I had a sponsored car. But suddenly I couldn't run for 8 months of the year and I was in a back brace. But what I learned from that was who my true friends were, was how to deal with the process, was what to do with my life, and to know that this wasn't the end. And, you know, that got me through it. And then the following year I made the Olympic team in 2008 at the age of 19, and then I went on to get a world medal in 2009, so in the relay team. And that's sort of the way you've got to treat everything, in my opinion, just being positive and finding something to look at in a positive spin. I've got a lot of favourites in terms of the sprint game. Usain Bolt is obviously one of them. Being able to race against him through his career, that's a good milestone in my life, just to be able to be a part of such a big era.
Oh, they're away, and Gatlin got away brilliantly, and he's ahead of the field at the moment, and Bolt going very in. Here comes Usain Bolt! Usain Bolt storming through, he takes it again, Blake gets the silver, 9.64! Oh, he's retained his title in the most emphatic way!
Suffer Powell, his first 60 metres is ridiculous, the way that the guy runs is very smooth.
Set.
Well, Powell out of the blocks well and coming through the phases and doing very well, also going well on the far side.
But then the likes of Maurice Greene, You know, those are the sort of those are the sort of athletes that I looked up to when I was younger. He did have the big pecs, he had the bravado, he was, you know, he's LL Cool J style, licking the lips, you know, he came with the flow. And it's just about the fact of what I've come to understand is, have your own game, be your own person. As much as good as it is to look up to people, use them as examples, because at the end of the day, you can't copy someone because we're all unique. Just be the best you. Don't be too disheartened if, you know, you're not able to, if you're not able to copy someone's technique, or you're not able to follow someone's path. You know, everyone has their own upsets and up and downs, and just to be sure that yours is a different journey, just use other people as examples. I wouldn't say that I've mentored any athletes. I'm 29, I'm still learning. You know, we never stop learning. But what I do is I'm fairly active on social media. When I do post something and there's questions asked, I answer them. I answer them, because there's nothing wrong with taking 2 minutes of my time just to explain what I'm doing and why I'm doing it and how I got there. But, you know, it's just about if that makes a difference. You know, I do get people saying that I'm inspiring to them, and that's great. You know, that's inspiring for myself to know that I'm doing something that's enabling other people to feel positive in some sense or shape or form in life, and that's what it's about. And that gives me something to drive on and move forward with. So that's a helpful message for myself.
For all aspiring boxers, we now present to you Tossin.
I discovered boxing through college and a friend. He brought me to a youth club where I started training with a coach, which led me to Fist for Lodge. I found this dream through a coach. My first time in was a different type of experience. Like, as you can see when you walk in, you know, you kind of feel like the old school, you know, sort of environment, and it really makes you want to be part of it too, you know. What makes you unique is the fact that it creates like a family sort of environment where everyone accepts you for who you are, and you really get to enjoy what we do. Like training your people or trying to get better. Some challenges, everyone has one. And when I started college, and it was pretty far from me, I sort of leave college earlier. I speak to my teacher, telling him sometimes that I have to leave early, you know, because I got training. Sometimes when I had work, I cancel my work because, like, you know, I felt like, you know, this is like one thing where I really had passion for. So I found reasons to get myself in here. And even right now, I also work right now full time. And after work, literally, I go leave my work at 5 o'clock, straight down here, and I'm back in doing what I do. And it's been difficult, but at the same time, it's been worth it, because it's just something that I got passion for, and nothing can stop me from doing it. Lomachenko, and I'm not sure like people know about him as much. I'm sure people do when they hear his name, but not boxing, you'll probably want to know his name. And he's an amazing boxer, you know. His talent is amazing. His footwork in the ring and the way he just like dances around and still gets hits.
I'll tell you this, Max. He threw some combinations while you were gone that were mind-blowing.
Good body shot. Oh,
another body to fly.
You know, like I felt like he's inspired me to like try to get me on the level where I need to be, like being a bit faster, you know, a bit more agility and all that. So I say it, Lomachenko, my favorite boxer. Trying to get into like tournaments and different competitions in the boxing, like after the ABAs, you know, Aaron Gay, you know, Box Cup, things like that, trying to get myself involved. For example, as well. And if I can get myself, you know, to go push myself as far as I can possibly push myself in this year, and I feel like, you know, in the next 4 to 5 years, at like 24, I should be where I need to be.
It's the simple things in life, simple things in life, simple things in life, simple things in life. Rolling dice, throw no aces with my gangsters. We discussing buying acres of
another safe bet. Nothing regular or basic. Riding back to back, me and Jungle in some spaceships. Where the squad at? You can see us on the app. Chop it up as always. Stand up, Queensbridge, not a world know us. Everybody saying my humility's infectious.